This is an example of one of the training videos in our FileMaker Certification Preparation course at ProductiveComputingUniversity.com. The evaluate function is very cool, kind of complicated. It has one or more parameters and returns just about anything and evaluates an expression as a calculation. Let's take a look. I've made a layout to demonstrate this a little bit better, the different features of it, because it does so much. And I have a calculated field called evaluate, and it is simply taking two text fields and passing those as the parameter and returning text. It's kind of like a mini calculator. If you just put in 1 + 1, it gives you the answer. If you put in 6 × 7, then you've got that answer too. It can do pretty much any random calculation very quickly and give you the answer. If you put in text though, it doesn't quite know what to do with that unless we actually put quotes around it. Now it has the right answer. And you can even mix and match if you like. Whatever you put in this field, it's actually going to do. So it's kind of like your own mini data viewer. Made a value list of some random functions, and you can see whatever I choose here, it just evaluates. It's all on the same field, just one feature, and really quite powerful. I'm demonstrating what it is showing here, but you should know that in the data viewer, if we add this in and just type something like current date, it doesn't give a result. But if we put quotes around it, then it knows what to do. But we're using fields in our example, and you can just quickly get information. You can put anything in there and it evaluates. The second part of the parameters is very interesting and is best described as dependencies. Not only will the evaluate function evaluate when this is changed, but it will also evaluate if this field changes. This field doesn't have to be in the calculation. It's just going to reevaluate if this field changes. So you notice I can put things in text field 1 and the field below is changing, but not this one. If I put something in field 2, now they both change. You might also notice that if I'm changing these, the mod timestamp is not changing because I'm still within this field. So I can constantly get this timestamp modification, but this one isn't changing until I actually leave the field. Lots of fun things you can do, but the most important thing I want you to get out of this is that you want to keep it very simple. By nested, I mean if you see a big, long, complicated looking formula, just break each one of these down into its smaller components and work it out on scrap paper if needed, and you'll see it's very simple. That's the evaluate function. You may want to test it out a little bit on your own and also see the let and quote function sections. I hope you enjoyed this sample from our FileMaker Certification Preparation course. Visit ProductiveComputingUniversity.com for more information about the certification preparation course and other training to help you save time as a FileMaker developer.